semuanya. Hari ini aku di sekolah hari Sabtu, tapi aku di sekolah karena hari ini ada performance acting karena aku ikut kelas yang namanya Integrated English Seminar A. Terus di kelas itu kita diajarin acting. Jadi hari ini aku bakalan tampil di panggung. Jadi pertama aku mau memperkenalkan guru Inggris aku, Mr. Paul Howell.
Hi everybody, my name is Paula Howell and I teach the IE Seminar A class at Aoyama University's on Friday afternoon. We just finished our performance, our morning performance, and I felt that Yuki was absolutely wonderful. In fact, I think she is ready for Broadway. No problem at all. It was very good. It was very enjoyable. They worked so hard in what they did. We spent months on this through rehearsal, building character, building work in what they did. So this performance, I will never forget. Back to you, Yuki.
Jadi semoga kalian suka performance-nya ya.
John Fargo.
Why do you ask?
Well, I was just curious. He told me about this place and said I should stop in. I wasn't sure if he was a regular or not.
Oh, I wouldn't call him a regular, but he has been here with time or two. He's a nice guy.
Yes, he is.
Oh, if you were excuse me, I have to have another customer.
Sleeping with John.
Excuse me?
You heard me. I want to know how long you've been sleeping with my boyfriend.
I'm sorry, miss. You must not be mistaken with someone else. I'm worried.
So, not only are you sleeping with my boyfriend, but you're cheating on your husband?
Look, lady, you have no idea what you're saying. I would appreciate it if you leave.
2 weeks ago, Thursday to be exact, I watched you with him. I knew something wasn't right. He was always working late and had every excuse as to why he couldn't be home on time, so I followed him.
Look!
Wouldn't you know it? He goes and finds himself some bimbo. Classy motel, by the way. What did that cost him? $9.95 an hour?
Look, babe!
Fuck you! I get two for the price of one. If John wants to ruin this relationship, fine. I can't wait to let him know he ruined another.
Please don't. My husband and I are just going through a rough patch. I made a mistake.
You think I give a shit? I loved John. Bet you didn't think about that while you're fucking him, did you? So, why should I give a shit about you?
You know what? You were right, but just remember, it takes two. You might want to think about why he was coming to me in the first place.
This isn't over.
Whoa. With the way Yuki played the scene where she came in and she tried to be nice at first. Because we'd already seen the scene, we knew that she had something to say. But she started off, oh, hi. But there was a couple of wonderful moments which were silent, and I want to mention something about it. And I thought, wow, that's clever. Niku was just sitting here, and I'm sorry, the waitress, what's your name again?
Katomi.
I'm sorry?
Katomi.
Katomi. Katomi was over there wiping some dishes and so on. Yuki looked over at her, and it was a wonderful moment. Such moments we love in theater. She didn't say a word, but she looked dagger. She went, wow, great moment. She really understands that.
In the water throwing. That is a wonderful opportunity, and I'm so glad you guys had this great piece to work. That is a marvelous opportunity for actors to see how they can make that work, right? So I loved watching how you guys, you know, strategize that. You've got to be close enough that the water could conceivably hit the person in the face, because that's the idea. When women are fighting in a restaurant, they throw glasses of drink. That's what they do, right? Guys don't do this in a restaurant. This is a woman's in a restaurant fight thing, right? And they're aiming to mess up the hair and makeup of the other woman. It's got to hit her in the face and in the hair, especially, right? That's the idea. And it's a complete disrespect thing, right? So they've got to be close enough that it can conceivably work. But if they are so close that they're right in the face of the person when she throws it, the other woman is going to reach over and scratch her eyes out, right? So I would say it's got to be close enough for them to have the anger and the tension, but it can't be so close because it doesn't feel natural that the person would turn and walk away. I think any woman who you're right in her face and you throw water at her, she's going to turn, she's going to start fighting, right? American women, those violent American women, right? So I think that is a challenge of how to make that work. But it was so fun seeing you guys work that out between you. And I thought it was really, really a great acting exercise. Altogether, I think everybody was listening, all four members, feisty, brought what they needed to the role. And I just, it was, thank you so much for giving this to us. It was interesting. There was never a moment that was not, what are they going to do next, right? Which is what we hope for in any theatrical performance. So good work. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Jadi ini kantin yang di sekolah, yang di kampus maksudnya. Jadi kalau mau pesan makanan di kantin, kita bisa lihat menunya ada di sini. Dan habis itu kita bisa beli makanannya di sini, kita beli tiket dulu. Habis kita beli tiket makanannya, kita bisa ngambil makanannya di sini. Kita harus antri sesuai dengan nomor-nomor yang ada. Jadi kita mau makan apa, kita antrinya di mana. Dan kalau kita mau ngambil minum, kita bisa ngambil minum di dispenser ini. Jadi yang itu ada teh hijau panas sama dingin sama ada air putih. Biasanya kelasnya ada di sini, tapi hari ini kok kayaknya habis ya. Dan ini semua gratis. Di kantinnya di dalam situ, dan di luarnya ada kursi-kursi banyak, dan kita juga bisa makan di luar. Di kampus juga ada toko buku, dan tadinya mau rekam di dalam sih, cuman ada kayak tanda kita nggak boleh ngerekam, jadi aku ngerekamnya dari luar aja. Di sini juga ada jualan Al-Quran, tapi mahal banget harganya. Di kampus juga ada 7-Eleven. Tapi kalau pas makan siang, terkadang terlalu ramai sampai nggak bisa jalan. Dan yang di depan itu pohon Natal kita. Kapan hari mereka nyalain dengan lampu yang berwarna-warni pas malam. Karena sekolah kita sekolah Kristen, makanya kita juga ada chapel, kayak gereja kecil gitu. Terus gedungnya tinggi banget. Sekarang lagi musim dingin, makanya pohonnya hilang daun-daunnya sampai gundul. Tapi nanti tumbuh lagi kok. Sampai beberapa hari yang lalu, banyak daun-daun kuning di jalanan, tapi sudah disapu.
Video kali ini, dan jangan lupa like, comment, dan subscribe. Sampai ketemu lagi ya, bye bye.